Hit me!
You know what? I think we're gonna be friends. Special friends. And when I'm with friends, I like to have fun!
What's up, fellas? Now I know your belly's ready for some of this egg styrofoam. It's off the chain, baby. You ready to fill them stomachs up with some hot cheese and eggs?
Son, this is the game. I'm playing his ass. That's my job. That's your job.
I started saying, it's a spiritual battle won by pedophiles. All of eternity is before you, and it's all a giant loop. You're like the past, the present, the future, all of it. And you're like, it's not just the past, the present, the future. That's only one spectrum, third dimension. Then you can delve as deep as you want to go, and you're like, the Satanists want to serve this? Why, the secrets of Satanism take 30 seconds to know. To even look into the heights of higher dimensions in God is just is Valhalla to the next level. And then you wonder, how could they do this? Because they were given power in this dimension.
Yeah, right.
And oh my God, he's gay. I just stare at him. Oh my God, shit, he's gay. And he's not gay, so he's really gay. You know, he says, well, nothing, because it's cool to be gay. It's not, I think it's not cool at all. I think it's,
That's what I'm talking about. This shit means something to me, man.
I think that my anti-gay, anti-fematic, they go conservative, right, and conservative extraordinaire.
There's kids in here who don't learn like that. They need to learn face-to-face. You're just getting mad if you don't point out the
eyes. I wasn't getting enough sex. I needed an outlet for my pent-up testosterone. I started lifting weights and eating a lot of steak. I began to put on muscle mass and was in better shape than I had ever been in.
Aerate it, warm it up, driving up that top note, that cream, pure vanilla, sweeteners. That's a 10.
That's what I'm fucking talking about! Let's go!
Welcome to War Mode.
What would I have done?
Yeah.
I would have done a legitimate investigation to find out what exactly happened on 9/11. How did they know who did this so quickly like they did Lee Harvey Oswald?
Who's going to investigate the investigators? Who's going to investigate the prosecutors? Who's going to hold them accountable? Who's going to hold us public officials accountable? And that's all we're trying to do here, in addition to trying to find the truth.
Do you honestly and truly in your heart believe that Sandy Hook actually happened? Yes or no?
No.
All right, number two.
And I'm here to tell you, 1776 will commence again if you try to take our firearms.
Because you're in jail.
Secretary Clinton.
It's only just begun.
Speaking of sophisticated, it's nice to be around another sophisticate after we're...
You're sophisticated. You drink, you pair, was it red or what?
It was red.
Do you remember the year and the name?
Yeah, I mean, after being on that low-level fucking podcast.
Napa, France, where were we?
Probably someone from Italy, cuz. I'm not sure. I mean, yeah. I just, last night, most people go out and get blind drunk, and not saying that's like, that's not my bag. I have friends that get blind drunk, but like I just, you know.
Okay.
I just got some pizza last night at a reputable place, a few glasses of vino with a nice young woman, and then, you know.
And then you know what?
I went and saw my my friend. I chilled there. But dude, it was there was like checkpoints and shit last night.
Yeah, no shit. It's the biggest drinking night of the year. I think it is.
I wasn't ready for that.
I think that is the biggest one. More than the other, more than like St. Patty's Day and the pub crawls and all that.
Yeah.
I think last night's the biggest night. Because everyone comes home.
It's crazy.
Yeah, like everybody comes to their home.
The cherries and berries were definitely out, I can tell you that much.
Oh yeah, dude.
But
it's a fundraiser.
I mean, drink responsibly. I didn't get too fucking crazy. We had to do this. And I really like it takes the wind out of you for 3 days.
Yeah, I just spent all night getting into King Arthur. I was really? A very good boy last night.
Dude, I was stone cold sober and I went to my buddy's house. And, these dudes were sitting around the fire and this one kid I hadn't seen in forever, he goes, "Yo, you remember me?" Like, people always say that shit to me. I was like, "Yeah, dude, obviously, we're not 70. I know who the fuck you are. I obviously remember you. I fucking hung out with you maybe 5 years ago." And he just he starts asking me how I'm doing. I'm like, "Yeah, fine." He's like, "How's everything going?" "Good." I ask him. Right when I ask him, he just goes, "We're all fucking pawns." It's like, what? Because we're all fucking pawns. It's like,
we're all pawns. We're deep.
What do you mean? He was like, I was like, "Yeah, but what are you doing?" He's like, "I'm electrician." It's like, that's sick, dude. That's not pawn shit. That's not low level pawn behavior. You're fucking bringing electricity places. He goes, "Dude, doesn't matter. We're just fucking pawns." I was like, "Bro, I'm not ready for this level of truth bombs." I've never had that gear when I got drunk to just sit there and think that I'm a cog in the wheel, dude.
Yeah, yeah, you're part of the wall.
Yeah, it was fucking insane. And then it was just like, I was up until probably 2. I got home at 2 o'clock. And the drive home, I was so tired. I haven't done a drive like that since I was 20 years old, working real, we would have weird shit where we just show up at night and have to do some stupid shit. And those drive homes, I was almost falling asleep. And tired driving is as bad as buzz driving. So
definitely, dude.
Shouldn't do shit like that.
Falling asleep behind the wheel is not cool.
Yeah, I was super tired. I had the window down. I had some Jones on, so I wasn't too tired, but I was damn, dude. That sucks for truckers who have to go cross country. And dude, they're falling asleep. They're trying to get the fucking pay to the plant. And they're just fucking assing out. And I feel for those bros, but obviously you should pull over and fall asleep. But dude, it'll get you. If you're
it's a black dog.
There's no lights out. When I drove, me and Tom went to Florida and we came back up, South Carolina, there's no fucking lights. I was going through at night, I felt like I was a Martian. It was fucking insane.
Yeah, but, I've never done a really long drive.
What's the longest you ever went?
Maybe Pittsburgh.
Really?
Yeah.
You've never driven that long?
That's it.
Damn, son.
Yeah, man.
I went down to Florida and back.
When I was 20, 21, maybe 20, we went to Pittsburgh.
And that's your longest haul?
In a car, yeah, I think.
Damn. Yeah, we went down, me and Tom went down to Florida and we drank, I think, 150 seltzers combined there and back.
I think I was on, I think I did some Boston in high school. That's I think not we bad. Did, I think we did, no, it was Connecticut. I don't know, that was a long one too.
I mean, it is pretty long. I was surprised that Connecticut isn't that far away. I learned that last weekend.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I mean, dude, you sent me that Balenciaga video, and that's
oh, yeah. Did you get into that?
I watched the whole fucking thing.
I love that Adderlite, dude.
Yeah, I didn't know. He's the best. That's perfect fucking stuff to watch. That's what I like. That's
maybe not the best stuff, but.
No. I'm saying the way, just a nice little breakdown of that. No fucking, here's also the ExpressVPN that I have and the gold.
Oh, I gotcha.
Breaking that down. I didn't know that, I knew, it's weird enough that you have, teddy bears in bondage, and, they're trying to throw the set director under the bus, and it's dude, you have to buy those things. All this shit, the way they wrapped up the caution tape and stuff, and, the way they covered stuff and showed B-A-A-L, someone is obviously a Satanist who's setting this up, because there's, if it was one fucked up thing, I get it, but the whole, the kid with the black crow in the background and stuff, this shit is demonic.
Actually, the photographer came out and was like, "Yo, dude, so they put his name on it, this guy, Gabriella Galimberti."
Right.
And he came out and was like, "Yo, man, all this shit of just the stills of the, if you zoom in on the desk and you see the pedophile, this child porn thing, yeah. Supreme Court or whatever." He's like, "I didn't take these." So, someone else, they had, another photographer come in and do this, and they lumped it into the photo shoot. And this dude's name is on it, and he's like, "Yo, this has nothing to do with me." He's like, "I'm not into any of this shit."
Holy fuck, yeah. Are you kidding
and
me?
And his pictures are definitely, his style is definitely, kind of weird.
Yeah.
But not to this extent.
So, this dude came on, and they just completely did another photo shoot, obviously placing this shit in plain sight. You can't get rid of Kanye. And do that,
dude, he doesn't set up this, he claims, this is his statement, "I'm only solely requested to light the given scene and take the shots." So he's so, not laying it out.
But he took the pictures?
He took the pictures, but he didn't take, like, there's pictures in this thing that he was like, I didn't even take that.
Oh, so someone's just snapping a shot and putting it in there with him.
Yeah.
I mean, dude.
And the thing with the artist, the other picture that they have on their website with the girl kicked back at the desk.
Yeah.
And they have the picture of, like, the babies eating each other. This is what I'm talking about. This is the shit I'm always talking about with the art.
Yeah.
Where it's like, this is fucking nutty. It's like, dude, I get it. Art's art. But why are the, like, why is this what they're into?
There's like, it's a universe, dude, that we live in. There's a world of cool shit.
You can draw whatever you want, brother.
You
can
put pictures, orangutans are funny as fuck.
Blank, it's a blank canvas, dude.
Especially for, like, a kid. Like, I get if you want to be some, like, weird edgelord and, like, put edgy shit up. Like, I get that.
I definitely think that the best case scenario in the Balenciaga thing, because I never heard of this before. I didn't know it was clothes. I don't know any of this.
I've never heard any wild shit like this from them, though. But, like, you're going to drop Kanye, and Kanye's going to watch H to N, and he's going to start spouting off this fucking stuff about the red media. And you are going to, like, you're going to be like, we're getting rid of him because of the horrible things he said. And then put this up.
But I'm saying, like,
what's the play?
I could see how this is, like, them thinking this would be a cool troll, but it's not. You know? Like, I think I get
you
how...
You could just put him in a yarmulke. You didn't have to fucking do that.
No, I get how they'll be like, oh, yeah, we'll put Ball in there. Like, this is like all the fucking...
Dude, that's a troll to, like...
This is the...
The deep.
This is the Bohemian Grove Pizzagate hole. And, like, we'll troll all these dudes. I could kind of see, like, a bunch of fashion art nerds.
Yeah.
Being like... Like, we were in New York once together, and we saw some of their behavior in an office... Working on something.
Yeah, yeah.
You could imagine this going down in a place like that.
Edomites, yeah.
Yeah.
it's insane.
You know what I mean?
Like, to do all this stuff and just be like, what, dude? Like, everything is perfectly placed. Like, when you're watching a movie, like you're saying with the Kubrick stuff, everything in the shot is perfectly fucking placed. It might as well be a painting.
It's especially with cartoons and drawings. So, like, drawings and cartoons are even more so than photography.
Yeah.
But that's the thing that freaks me out with the Disney stuff. Like, you're saying Encanto's bad. I don't know why yet. You still have not elaborated on that yet. You just say it's bad.
Yeah.
You don't even want to tell me.
You don't trust me?
You don't even want to tell me. It's like, I have to sit there with Maya and watch it.
No, here's the thing.
I watched the beginning of that movie 3 times now. Here's my goddaughter. And you're trying to tell me that I'm in too deep.
This, based off of just how I feel, I think it's bad. But the problem is, you get rid of all of our good videos where we can look this shit up, and then you have to rumble it. And when you rumble it, it's the most clickbait shit. And it's like Encanto, pedophilia, all this stuff. But they never get to it.
You know how you're talking about how I always fall for clickbait?
Yes.
The most clickbait thing I fall for is like, I almost did it today. I stopped myself and I still want to scratch this itch. It was Sylvester Stallone was leaving this world. Here's his final message. And it's a picture of like... A dude in a deathbed kind of looking like Stallone, and I'm like, is Stallone dead? You know what I mean? Like, it'll get me every fucking time, dude.
It's insane because, like...
I'm retarded.
Someone's making money off that.
I know.
That's a crazy hustle. Like,
it's like, just like, this person's dead.
Yeah, I mean...
Can't believe they're gone too soon. gone too soon, celebrities get me.
Same shit happens to me. Like, there's, like, Instagram stuff and, like, stories where, like... Girls will like, it's like a filter, and they'll put something on their head, like, who are you most like, celebrity? And it's just a random pinwheel, and it'll just like say whatever. And like, dude, I'll be sitting there, like, looking at it, just like, oh, yeah, I wonder what it is. Like, sit there, oh, yeah, that's crazy. And I watch the whole thing, and like, I catch myself, like, dude, you're a fucking retard. Stop doing this. It's insane. But yeah, I mean, the Balenciaga stuff is pure debauchery. And it also reminded me, like, I was chilling. Remember, I got you the Chino yesterday?
Oh, yeah.
The whole time I'm chilling there, like, fucking Starbucks is insane. Like, I just chill, wait for my fucking order. It gets hammered from mobile orders. Like, there's millions of drinks. If you want free drinks, dude, walk into Starbucks. You can get drinks whenever the fuck you want. You just snag them, dude. I'm sitting there right next to me. I'm minding my own business. There's these two chicks. They're lesbians together. It doesn't matter. On her shirt... She had a shirt that just is a hoodie, and it just said "Cum Angel."
What?
I texted you that yesterday.
I thought you were fucking around.
No, this chick just had a shirt that said "Cum Angel."
Should have snapped the pic.
Dude, like
should have snapped it. It was worth it. That's worth it.
It's just us.
That's worth it.
But like, dude, like,
I would have got it, and you know that.
I think this edgelord stuff's going a little too far because you can't be in Starbucks with a shirt that says Cam Angel. At first, I thought it said Cam Angel, and I was like, this is a cam. Or it didn't look like, it wasn't like, she's not putting out premium content by looks, you know what I mean? Maybe she, maybe for other guys.
Wow, dude. Not, wow, bro.
But then.
Go on one date.
No, she's out there with the Cam Angel shirt, and then her friend's like, oh, I'll take a picture, and she's doing the peace sign over both of her nipples. So, like, her nipples are going out through both of her peace signs, and I just wanted to go full Islam. Yeah, that shit just fucking fazed me. See, like, you can't be wearing shit like that, and then, like, being, like, I might have looked at her 17 times.
Yeah, I don't understand the,
Like, it's so geeked out with me that openly, like, either horny or just doing the weird in public.
I don't understand pushing the weird BDSM shit with kids. Like, I just don't get it. So I don't understand, like, what kind of boundaries pushing that is. You know, like, I don't understand. Even if you're saying, like, an edgelord, like, so that we're taking it to the edge. It's like, what's the edge here?
Edge of what? Yeah.
The edge of fucking abducting kids?
Yeah, it just, it's a horrible look.
Like, isn't the entire BDSM thing, like, weird consent? Where, like, you're consenting to be in, like, a weird pleasure pain situation, and then there's safe words and shit. It's like, dude, like, children can't make decisions.
Yeah, they can't consent.
So, like, why would you be doing this? Like, why would you...
You might be breaking down their fucking message.
What do you mean?
Children can consent.
I know that that's their argument.
They're begging for that.
Yeah, I know that that's their argument.
Out of all the things you could possibly worry about, like, to on the forefront of your minds, like, children can consent, whether it's, like, being a tranny or have
sex.
Well,
if you're an elite, there's only one thing you're still not allowed to do.
Bang
and
kids.
Back in the day, the elites used to be able to do it. So it must phase them. Because, like, it's carte blanche, dude. You can do whatever the fuck you want. If you have enough money, you can do whatever you want. They're coming up with reverse aging, all this shit.
That shit's fucking crazy.
And then out of nowhere, they're just, like, you know, pushing this weird... They push this weird shit. This weird agenda has been going on for what, like 5-6 years now?
Yeah, I just get real phased because it's a team of people who put this together. It's not an accident. Like,
yeah, I was checking it out, and one of the guys said that when they do these kind of like when they come out with a campaign,
yeah,
or whatever you want to call this thing, it's a team of people that work for the company, and they spend about 2 years on it.
What?
Yeah, like that's how long these things.
That photo shoot, 2 years.
This fashion stuff, the whole concept of it. I don't know. This is just hearsay. Yeah. This is just some dude talking. But
I can believe it.
I'm saying, like, you get into these companies, it's like, these ad runs aren't nothing. They're not just shitting these things out. Yeah, like, they fucking, people, this is someone's job.
Yeah, I just think, like, to do this after getting rid of the Yeezy, it doesn't make sense. It's not a troll. Like, this is just some weird shit, like... And, like, dude, you see it with elite kids. They have fucking bedrooms like that. Like, when you're painting the elite kids' bedrooms, they got scribbles all over the wall. They're fucked up in the fucking head. So, worst case or best case scenario, this is just some fucking weird.
You're talking about I Love Doggy.
I Love Doggy.
Yes. I forgot about that, man.
Yeah,
fuck.
I'll never forget about it until the day I die. So, like, elite kids kind of scribble fucking crazy shit over their wall. All I'm hoping is that this is just some weird elite kid. It was like, well, my bedroom looked like this, and, like, my parents just kind of let me have teddies with BDSM.
It's crazy that the I Love Doggy house ended up being, like, Hate Has No Home Here, blasted all over it. Like,
dude.
It's crazy.
It's fucked
the messaging, that the messaging going on there. It's like the parents are scribbling on their front windows, kind of. It's, like, the same deal.
That shit makes zero sense to me. I don't know. Like, it's... If you're putting that stuff up, you got nothing going on. Because I got, like, a sick picture of JFK in my fucking front window.
Yeah.
That's fucking sweet. Like, if you put that shit up, that's cool.
I was trying to find all these cool, like, Camelot things with fucking JFK. There used to be a cool video that I watched.
You had a Camelot JFK comparison.
I had
a
thing.
Ago.
Do you remember that? And yes. It was, like, how it was, like, all about, like, the sacrifice of the kid. And, like, I couldn't find it. It's something. It's the sacrifice of the king. It's, like, sacrifice of the king. And, like, it's an ancient, like... Druid thing. It's an ancient,
really?
Like, pagan.
Why'd you start getting into King Arthur? Like, what happened?
Well, I was watching all that. It was JFK's, the anniversary of him getting assassinated.
Are you comfortable talking about this?
So I'm fine. I diverted. I got into, like, I was like, oh man, I want to check out that Camelot shit. And then I got into just Camelot in general. And that there's been a mega, mega conspiracy against King Arthur. Trying to create King Arthur as a myth.
Yeah.
King Arthur's an actual dude. There's actually two Arthurs. They found out where Camelot is. It's in Wales. And there's a, they're like, they, they're, it's like the line of Glenmorin or something like that. And like these kings, the line of King Arthur would exist today. There are people with royal blood, but they've been.
They're on the can't be killed list.
Right now, the.
They have Templars or no? Templars are after them.
After them. The current, the Windsors, dude, are usurpers. They are not.
They usurp like the Britain. Throne?
Britain is Wales. The southern, like they're the Britons.
Yeah.
And you have England is up north and Scotland's up north. And it's like the Britons.
Yep.
They, you know, that was a kingdom.
Who's then, responsible for like who
and
was.
And then in the, dude, know, they used I'm to teach that. It. They used to teach it in the 20s. They were, people were still speaking Welsh. And this is a thing over there. Like, there's Irish.
People shit on Welsh too. Like, if you speak Welsh, be like, dude, fuck off.
There's Irish, there's Scottish, there's all these languages that they just fucking iced. England was like, yeah, fuck that, we're not going to teach it anymore. They just had English-speaking teachers, and they erased the history, they rewrote the history. So there's this really cool documentary where this guy says that there's all the way up to the 1700s, there's British history, British, like, yeah. With the brutes.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
Like, fucking, here you go. And King Arthur's in there, and then they just wipe it. And then, like, 1800s, for, like, political reasons, they rewrite history in, like, a crazy Orwellian fucking scam to delete history. And then they'll come at you for fucking thinking there's mud floods. It's like, bro, they fucking rewrote British history for the in the budding empire when it was like, all right, we're about to take over the world. King Arthur's just a myth.
Yeah, I mean, W.E.B. Du Bois might be on notice right now that you're telling me this stuff, because like you had the Roman Empire and all this stuff, and they're just like, oh, they went over to Ireland, they were just chilling in the woods. It's like, so you had the Roman Empire happen. They're the only ones killing it. Like, there's all sorts of shit. Life has went on way before that, and these people were just in the woods. Like, they might have been doing sick shit, and for some odd reason, like, when you're
hiding... They were carving stone.
When you're hiding the truth that hard from me, it's something real mega. And maybe I won't think of my ancestors as fucking people who are just fucking in public and mongoloids.
Well, they could also just be doing it to get rid of the bloodlines. So there's, like, a Welsh... There's a Welsh-British royal bloodline that's out there. People are cruising around with king blood.
Yeah, and then maybe they might not be that susceptible to lies.
Perhaps.
Mayhaps. I understand you.
Yeah. You stand under me.
Yeah, dude. Like, that shit is fucking crazy because they did wipe that out. Like, they came in there and
who... Dude, like, my whole life, I'm like, oh, yeah, King Arthur's like this crazy archetypal myth.
I thought it was a cartoon
and
my whole life.
And, like, if you asked me... I would say, okay, yeah, it's like the 500s or whatever. And then there was that big 536, like the year with no summer. Like, it was some volcano cold, erupted. Yeah. And that's the whole origin story of, like, Avalon and fucking Arthur coming, bringing the harvest and, like, the king. It's all this, like, weird archetype myth shit, right?
Yeah.
When in reality, it's been documented. This dude has the documents. He's got the family tree. There's two Arthurs. God. Yeah.
That is fucking insane.
Yeah, there's two Arthurs, yeah.
I just don't understand.
So there's Arthur the First, and then he's dealing with the Romans, and then there's Arthur the Second, and then there's like a comet involved. It's a crazy conspiracy. King Arthur conspiracy. Pretty easy to find.
YouTube?
Yeah, YouTube.
Yeah. It does pump me up when you start unearthing ancient history. Like that ancient apocalypse show, when they're showing all that stuff, like...
Dude, if they do a season two of that, Graham Hancock can go to Camelot. That'd be sick.
That would be sick, honestly.
It might be too, like... modern for him because it's the 500s.
Yeah,
he's way back in like younger Dryas, but it does involve a comet and ancient buildings. The layout of Camelot's still there. They're walking around. They're like, this is the walls of the Camelot.
Are you serious?
Yeah, it's there. It's in Wales.
That is very fucking insane.
It's in Cardiff. It's by Cardiff, and like they have words for like round table in Welsh, but Welsh is so hard. We were just talking about this with Matt.
Yeah,
fucking Welsh is like so hard to understand.
You can't understand fucking shit.
So that's why I got into it. It was all connecting. Everything yeah. connect. All my dots connect. I'm sitting there like JFK, fucking, you know, and then Camelot, and then Welsh, and all, you know.
It is crazy. I mean, did anything ever happen with Trump releasing those JFK files?
They do this with that. They dick tease everybody. They can't do it because it involves state actors.
What?
They can't do it because it involves, like, countries.
Oh, okay.
I would imagine it's not just the mafia. It probably involves some kind of intelligence from some kind of countries.
Sure. Yeah. I believe that, like, Saudi Arabia.
They like that JFK would be over 100. I think he'd be like 105
right now.
Yeah,
are you serious?
I think so. Yeah,
holy fuck.
I mean, he was 40 in the 60s.
Makes sense, checks out.
But you know, they got to wait for everyone that's involved to die and then all the institutions that are involved to be like, not have a problem with it, I would imagine.
Is there any, there's nothing on this scale that's ever been released, right?
What's that?
There's nothing like on that level that's ever been declassified yet, right?
I mean, there's nothing on the level. There was not a lot of information taken down when they assassinated Abraham Lincoln.
Yeah, yeah, I guess so. That does fucking, I pray to God.
JFK is the biggest, it's definitely the biggest conspiracy because it's so much shit. That's why you can't like kick back and just bullshit about it. There's too much shit.
Yeah. And, that, it's,
and you have to know a ton of stuff.
It seems like there's a lot of dead ends on that too.
You have to know, like, you have to know his dad, and then you have to kind of know the world. You have to kind of be able to wrap your head around, like, the, remember when I was like, dude, watch Chinatown so we could talk about.
Yeah, yeah.
You kind of have to wrap your head around, like, the pro, like, 30s and 40s to get JFK, because JFK is in World War II. He's not being groomed to be president at all.
He was a beast in World War II, right?
His brother was supposed to be, his brother was being groomed to be president. So, like,
really?
Joe Kennedy was grooming his oldest son to be the president. He got shot down in a plane and killed in World War II. So it's like, up next, JFK. But JFK was like a quiet second brother.
Damn, I can relate, bro.
Yeah, for real, dude. And then he just like traveled the world and like he just like read books and had a diary. And there's a lot of shit, dude. Like apparently, yeah, like he was fucking like JFK was a hornball. He was fucking like a Nazi spy. So like J. Edgar Hoover had that on him. Like there's tons of shit. It's so much stuff.
It seems like there's like...
Like everybody wanted to take out the fucking Kennedys. And then their CIA writes all these books about like the Kennedy era.
Yeah.
Where it's like they make them look really bad. And you're like, dude, there was a couple of things.
And the CIA hates him because he was trying to shut that shit down, right?
There was a couple of things in their foreign policy that were rubbing people the wrong way.
Not
and like,
good.
Not good. Yeah. And like they would have been... We would be living in a way different world. Like we would probably have colonized Africa in a way.
Sarah Jassar.
You know all the shit that they did when they did, like, they took out South America?
Yeah.
When they were like, just do all that shit.
All that shit.
They would have done that shit to Africa. And we would have probably have all Africa's natural resources, because JFK started out in Africa.
Oh, my God.
Probably. I'm just guessing. Like, I'm just shooting the shit with you.
Yeah.
But I'm just saying there's too much, there's too way too much stuff.
Yeah, I mean, it is an impossible fucking rabbit hole, but it's crazy the fact the amount of just, disinfo that's out on that.
Yeah, it's, I mean, to just be like... Just be like, this guy, the guy said he was a patsy before he was killed by Mr. Rubenstein, so.
Yeah, yeah, it is insane. That dude.
We're not talking about high math here.
Yeah, it's pretty open and shut. But the like the shit that's fucking me up is watching all, your shit's going off again. All right, yeah, I did not pay attention to that fucking club shooting at all. Like, I haven't, like. Really, I haven't done a fucking thing of it. All I knew it was Club Q, and they had a fucking drag queen and some army vet take the person out. It's the only thing I fucking knew.
I don't know anything about it besides the fact that Dick Delaware is the dad.
Dude.
That's killing me because we used to have a porno in the house that I used to live in with Dick Delaware.
I just
and he's famous for getting a Blumpkin.
You saw it was on that video you had?
I don't know if it's on that one or not.
Dude, I just want to live a normal fucking life. And I was cool with that. It's like, oh yeah, drag queen and army vet killed, stopped a mass shooter. Sweet. Why the fuck are you going to interview Dick Delaware and say it's the dude's dad?
Is it not his dad?
Dude, I don't even think the thing happened now. You can't have fucking Dick Delaware out there like, I'm a Republican and, you know, I like, he names a fuck. Like, Dick Delaware, it has to be like, it's Thanksgiving. Everyone's probably with their family.
Happy Thanksgiving, man.
They probably pulled him up from the trenches like, dude, we need you to be this guy's dad. It's, all right, look, dude, I just hit a lot of meth. You can interview me, but I don't know how this is going to go. It's like, just name this politician. When he was sitting there, did you watch the one from the dude? When he's sitting there, he like out of nowhere just names his politician. It's like, dude, this is the fucking fakest shit in the world. It makes no sense. Say, like, dude, same with the Pulse stuff. That Pulse thing was not that cool.
Go on.
I'm just
elaborate.
Like, I'm just saying, like, this. Why are you doing this? Like, you, like.
Do you think there could be a shooting that you'd believe?
At this point, no. Like, and they did this to me. You can't have fucking Dick Delaware be the dude's dad.
This was your
don't interview him.
This was your original vampire bite.
Shooters.
This is what turned you,
dude. Because like, it's funny to say it didn't happen. every aspect of life. If someone's like, oh, like this happened, you just say it didn't happen, it makes me laugh. And I've been told recently that my humor is in poor taste and things I say are inappropriate, and I'm trying to be better. But dude, it's like when I see like, oh man, that's hilarious to say. Like an obviously wrong thing is hilarious to say. Now, that could just be a funny joke. But then you're CNN or you're Fox 5 or whatever, and you hit me with Dick Delaware, the dude who got a blumpkin on video, cracked out of his fucking mind.
I mean, he's probably been doing meth and like porn drugs for at least like 15 to 20 years.
Yeah, that's fucking insane. Yeah.
Like, so, that's a lot. He's got that underbite jaw thing going on.
Alpha.
Like, he's got a lot going on.
But like, dude, if you're the news and you see this guy, like, he's fucked up on drugs and you're going to interview him, and like, he's sitting there like eyes darting around. Like, I have to talk about Republicans. I have to talk about Republicans and Mormons. It makes no sense.
I mean, it kind of makes sense to me because I know that, and I know this is fucked up, but I know that those guys do gay stuff.
Who?
Porn stars.
Yeah.
They
have to.
Yeah. So he's obsessed with like not his kid not being gay, if he's the dad at all.
If Dick Delaware is the father.
I'm just saying, yes. He's just like, all he cares about is if his kid's not gay.
It would be spun out on meth.
He's spun out. He's like, I mean, he's not gay. He shot up a gay club. I would conclude he's not gay.
Yeah.
It's like, yeah, dude, I mean, you're probably jammed up about something you did. You've been on drugs for fucking 20 years. Like, I don't think he's like Monarch MK Ultra.
Yeah.
But I'll tell you what, those Balenciaga pictures look like the grooming of little monarchs, like a young Disney Mickey Mouse kid.
Yeah.
You know, like, that's a weird, dark...
I mean,
that's like, the tails of the coin there, man. Like, when I look at that shit, I'm like,
because
oh, wow.
Porn's almost too good to be true if you're a dude. Like, everyone be lining up and be like, oh, I'm just going to fuck chicks on camera, whatever.
Yeah.
But every single one of those dudes...
You're in a room with like a bunch of other dudes.
But there's a video of them, like they all do gay shit. Like, to get into porn, you have to do gay shit.
It's like getting jumped into a gang.
Pretty much. I don't know what gang that is. Not a part of it. I was accused of being homophobic on Matt Shane Secret Podcast.
Really? Wow.
I'm gay, I'm homophobic. I'm skinny, I'm fat, dude. I can't win. But like, this shit, if you want me to believe Dick Delaware, have it not be Dick Delaware. Just have me, literally any other actor. The odds of the dude getting a blumpkin being the father of the mass shooter makes me think we're obviously in a simulation, because that's just some funny shit.
Yeah,
I do.
Every
if
once
I was
in a
gaming
while,
on myself, that's some funny shit.
Every once in a while, they're just hitting us with the keck for laughs.
It literally makes no sense. And if you want, oh man, why do I have to fucking always do this?
I'm just saying, like, if you were the parent or family member of someone that died in tragedy, it'd be brutal to be sitting there watching Dick Delaware just talk about how his kid's not gay.
Yeah. It's in poor taste.
You know? That's in poor taste.
To fucking release that on the news, like,
I'd say
obviously.
That's the red media.
Yes. But, like, dude, I hate that I do this. Like, I don't want to not believe. I want to believe everything. I want everything.
You must have been hell on wheels with Santa.
With Santa? No, because it's fun. Like, when Santa was coming, I was like, okay, let's go.
You'd keep up the lie. You'd propagate the lie.
I wouldn't propagate the lie. I came to a realization probably around like third grade, maybe, whenever it was like normal. But there was kids in my class, and I kept my mouth fucking shut, because that is helping people. Like, this isn't helping people. This, like, I told you, this is going to be fucking weird shit when the elections start coming. We're going to get shootings. Like, dude.
We've had a bunch of shootings.
I know.
What's going on?
Well, it makes, this is the shit that gets me tripped the fuck out, because, dude, this shit is fake to me. All this shit. Because you have Muslims on jihads constantly. And if this was for a fucking religion and you were going to heaven if you killed yourself, and they really believe that, there would be mass shootings every fucking day until we were on our knees. It's made up. They're patsies, bro. They're fucking MKUltra freaks that get sent out to do this stuff, because no normal person in their right mind is shooting this stuff up. This is people who are egged on over and over and over again. Best case scenario, by some bad actor who wants this stuff to happen to help out some either politics or some weird shit. If you watch this dude who fucking stopped the shooter, He's reading. He's reading from a fucking teleprompter, dude. I don't know if it's a teleprompter or what, and I'm sorry I'm doing
You're lost cause.
Dude, they did this.
This is your bite, that's all.
I can't believe anything. When it happens, I'm just like, all right, like, I think this shit's fake. And in reality, dude, we're all fucking pawns. We're all just fucking pawns, dude.
Dude, speaking of pawns, I've been trying to play chess, dude. I suck. So I have a little app, and I get rocked.
Chess is very hard.
It's fucking insane.
If you go chaos mode, that's your only
I just
chance.
Go fast and start chucking up moves.
Yeah, I mean, you're Bobby Fischer. It's a difficult game, and it is crazy.
I get hit with, like, the screen shuts down, and then another, like, there's, like, a pop-up, and I'm like, I lost?
Yeah.
I didn't even see that coming.
We're definitely not chess aficionados, dude. I'll just think, like, the shit I was, like, reading about the Elsagate stuff, I think it was Elon Musk who said it, but I think he changed his name. I don't know. But it's
very old. The Elsagate, I remember.
It's so old, but, like, dude, it's the same shit where, like, YouTube's letting this shit happen and then just axing everyone who talks shit on fucking vaccines and all that stuff.
Yeah, I mean, I don't think social media or any of those companies give a fuck. Like, you're talking about the terrorists. They get recruited through Twitter.
Yes.
So, I mean, everyone's spazzing about Twitter right now. It's like, God, they, you know, have you ever seen the Afghan, like, ads?
No.
For their military?
Are they funny?
They're like, oh, it's hilarious. Well, like, their recruitment shit is fucking so nice.
Yeah,
they're doing like the crab walk crawls, all that shit.
Dude, what the fuck was that shit you were telling you? Like, you didn't get into it earlier in the week about FTX.
Oh yeah, FTX. Whitney Webb had an interview with two guys. One guy's brutal. He's got a fucking vocal fry for a dude. It's very hard to deal. Very hard to listen.
Is he trans?
Very hard to listen to, because it's like a monotone.
Yeah, that
and
puts you
just
to
zone
sleep.
Out. Yeah, but there's a lot of fun facts in that fucking. Dude's dad is an expert in, like, tax evasion.
You're cutting edge saying shut the fuck up about that.
Huh?
You were cutting edge telling me to shut up about that last week.
What do you mean?
Not shut up, but you're like, dude, there's way more to this than whatever the fuck's out right now.
You're watching a scripted film. Like, if
Patriots are in trusted positions.
Yeah, so there's a dude, the Sam Bankman-Fried guy. Have you seen the... Pause it for a second. I'll show you a video.
Yeah, I think...
Yeah, you see him working?
We're good.
Yeah, you see him shaking like that? Like, so
he might be fucking pinned on Adderall, too.
Yeah, sure, but he was running... No one's given actual money to someone like that.
No, that's a Spurglord. That's definition Spurglord.
But, basically, I think the Whitney Webb thing is cool. There's probably even more to come out. These two guys seem to know what they're talking about. They're talking about how that dude has a handler. The guy's name is, like, McCaskill or something like that.
Yeah, people freaked out about this McCaskill dude, like, right when he came out, because he's everywhere and nowhere all at the same time. He's like a ghost.
Well, he was on Lex Fredman's podcast, and Lex Fredman pulled the podcast and pulled the tweet. So someone tapped him on the shoulder and been like, yo.
Before all this happened.
I don't know. See, like, I'm just listening to a podcast. I'm just dude listening to a podcast.
Right, same.
And you're asking me questions about it.
Yeah.
So, but the guy, SBF's dad, does tax evasion expert. Teaches in tax evasion at Stanford, I think.
Tax evasion?
You know, like ways to not pay taxes, like how to set up, like, you know, accounts. Like
in the Bahamas.
Like Panama paper type shit. And then his mom runs this thing called Mind the Gap. Hilarious. And it's a thing about...
That's where you got that from? Oh, no. You're Missile Gap. You're fucked up on right now.
No, yeah. And that's where she
is hilarious.
She's running a thing where it's like, if you're super rich, you should donate to the poor and, like, close the gap.
Yeah.
So she has a, but it's a super PAC where they donate to the Dems.
The dirty Dems.
Yeah. So that's just his parents. He's got a handler, possible British intelligence. The dude is literally taking his wife's grandmother's maiden name or some crazy shit like that. It makes no sense.
You're off the, like, at that point, why don't you just make a name up?
Then he's in the discovery of the Elon Musk thing, and his tweets come out. McCaskill, I think that's his name, McCaskill.
It is. All right. Yeah.
He's tweeting, he's texting Elon Musk, you should use FTX as a way to fund your Twitter buyout. So he's like pushing.
McCaskill is.
Pushing.
And
fucking,
mind you, even if you're saying his name wrong, that's okay, because when you pronounce someone's name correctly, you're giving them power.
Exactly. It's a spell.
Yes.
That's why we spell.
Yes, exactly.
But yeah, like the. They were, like, just running a Ponzi scheme pretending they had money. They basically made up their own chips at the table, and they were like, "You can have STX."
They're tokens.
They sponsored the Miami Heat. They were sponsoring fucking sports teams like jerseys and shit.
Brady and Giselle.
Yeah, I never knew. Janelle's last name is Giselle. Bunchin.
Oh, don't give her power.
Yeah. Hilarious, dude.
Yeah.
I know, never knew that before.
Slam on her, dumbass supermodel.
Bunchin. But yeah, I don't know. It's a ton of shit with that FTX stuff. And a lot of people are wrapped up in it. It's not just like Larry David types.
Yeah,
you know? And they're chucking this dude up as kind of like a patsy to bring in regulation for crypto. They're chucking all these celebrities up to be like, look at who invested.
It's Tom Hanks getting COVID, dude.
Don't look at the fucking others. It's like, look at that. Look at Larry David. You know, yeah. Larry David.
Yes.
You know, the guys we created that you're supposed to love.
Yeah.
Look at them.
This is no different than the whole, like, Tom Hanks and Rita Wilson or whatever her name is get COVID.
And Whitney brought up a really good point. This is a lot like fucking Epstein's Island. Because it's just straight to, they were in a poly ninesome and fucking coming everywhere.
What's the lawyer's name? Dershowitz only wore his pants the whole time. That matters nothing. If Dershowitz had underwear on and I'm not standing up for him, man, he's a fucking pervert. But that does not matter about him if he took his skibbies off or not.
Yeah, I mean, it's all the salaciousness of it all.
That is crazy that, like, anytime any of this big shit comes, that's a very good fucking point. They just hit you with, like, the sultry. It's like, oh, man, you'll never believe it's actually perverts. Kind of like what they're everywhere.
So the red media is, like, obsessed with fucking perversion, so.
They really
constantly chuck that shit out there.
It's, like, this dude's, like, it's crazy that they try to say he's a genius because,
well,
like,
he's a physics kid from MIT, which is bizarre. He just gets plugged into finance.
That sometimes happens if you're super smart. Like, one kid I know is, like, real smart. He did, like, engineering at some school. And then they're like, nah, you're doing stock market stuff.
So him and his brother end up working this thing called Jane Street. And his brother ends up doing COVID disinformation management.
On ivermectin.
And he is just, like, this weird, like, money guru guy.
His brother, older or younger?
I don't know.
Okay.
And the crazy thing is that's what Epstein was. So Epstein was this, like, offshoot dude who did,
oof,
very rare dude. And then it's like, but he's this genius with money. And he's
sick with it.
And so this is technically a Ponzi scheme, mega. Epstein went down for the biggest Ponzi scheme in history at the time with that Stephen Hoffenberg dude that's always on the Oppenheimer Report for Tower Investments.
Yeah. But
so, like, it's the same playbook. And then it's like Epstein gets busted. They go to the salaciousness. They're just running a program, dude. This is like an algo. Like, this is, oh, wait, we got caught.
You're not following the money at all.
Yeah, it's like, oh, we got.
Charles Strain said it, dude. Follow the money.
It's like, oh, we got caught again. Oh, okay, yeah. They're all dating each other. Celebrities are involved. It's like Epstein gets busted. It's like, yeah, they're on an island. They're all fucking.
Dershowitz never took his underwear.
Celebrities are involved. You know?
You're dot connecting right now.
Can't help it.
It is crazy. Like, they're going to try to call this dude a genius. He tried to transfer $4 billion to Alameda. Just pull it out of one account, put it in the other. $4 billion, bro.
But in the podcast I was listening to, they brought up really good points. Like, you're not getting Super Bowl time, and you're not sponsoring the Miami Heat with FTX coins. That's actual cash.
It's all the cash they were using.
But where do they get money? So someone put up the money first. The guy that put up the money.
Fat cats.
The big guy who's like the fucking Les Wexner of all this to get SBF started is the dude that owns Skype.
Shut the fuck up.
Yep.
Are you serious?
Shut the front door, brother.
Holy fuck.
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, dude, it is crazy. Like, when they started, because if I'm watching this, like, because I watched like a few deep dives on it, every single person bid on that shit. Like, even me. Oh, dude, show me a sex tape. Give a fuck about FTX. Like, I want to see this little rat. Fuck them.
That's what they know that you're going
to. My lower self said that.
Your lower self is going to take over. They know they're going to play on your reptilian mind where you're just going to be like, her.
I don't.
And that's what you're doing. And, like, that's, you know, that's what everyone's going to be sitting there going, like, this is crazy. They're all just, like, in a weird relationship we can't understand that only these freak shows get into.
Yeah.
Like, you couldn't understand Epstein. Epstein had, like, a harem of fucking 20-year-old girls. And like, and a lot of them liked it, and they were getting paid, and like everything was fine. And this whole story is like, this whole story that they put out there, and I'm not saying that it's fake.
Yeah.
But it's like, that's the thing they promote about it. That's the truth that they promote about it.
Signal to the noise.
the signal to noise ratio is all fucked up because the noise is you've been involved in shit since Iran-Contra.
Yeah.
You know, like you're involved with Leslie Wexner and fucking Southern Air Transport. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like
you can't be getting that much money and then just like 30 years old to be running that and your brother running like the
Epstein's
disinfo.
The same thing.
Epstein
came out of nowhere, young man at fucking working at, I can't remember what it was. It was like
that
Chase
school.
Or something. No, he worked at the Dalton School, but then he went to like a firm. I'm blanking on the name, but it's like one of the main firms.
Guys.
The big guys, yeah.
I mean, I think you're right on. Like, whatever it is, whatever they're doing behind the scenes.
And then when Epstein started doing financial shit, he was getting like wicked returns, just like this dude. And then they were like, "Dude, what are you doing?" And they looked into it and they're like, "Yo, man, you can't do that. That shit's illegal."
Fuck.
It's the same exact thing that they constantly come up with these guys. Also, too, like these guys just exist. You just have scumbags that scam the system, and they're all kind of the same dude because. If you have this like criminal mind to do these Ponzi schemes, like you're probably kind of the same.
Yeah, definitely.
You know, like if you start thinking like, all this is sociopath shit. This is like, oh, you guys are all playing a game. Yeah. I'll bend the rules.
Yeah, I'll fuck everything up. I think I'm almost positive it's someone related to the SBF squad that they ran some finance company during COVID that got like 1,000% returns.
Yeah.
Like they knew COVID was coming, did all the right, stock options, whatever, however the fuck going on, I'm not involved, and got crazy ass returns. And then this,
well,
dude,
they were connected to, possibly connected to John Hopkins running Event 201.
That's you.
I was telling you this the other day.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. This makes sense.
Yeah.
Yeah. So if this is tied up in Event 201, and with the rollout of the digital dollar, this makes complete sense. Where like, oh, let the pros step in.
Yeah.
Take over this. Coins and all this stuff, it's all fucked up. We're going to give you the digital dollar. Because they already tried to release this stuff. And digital currency is part of Event 201, right?
It's part of the Great Reset and all that stuff.
Yeah, because Klaus Schwab...
Event 201's about the media like rollout of a pandemic.
Okay, yeah. So Klaus Schwab's like coming out now, beating his chest like, we did the Great Reset. Like, this shit's sick.
I don't know. It freaks me out because all this kind of stuff... They're obsessed with controlling finances and healthcare.
Yeah. That's not good, bro.
Not good.
Yeah, I think this was a full-blown, like, because you kneecap most kids that were into crypto. And, like, dude, when this shit goes on and everyone's making money and having fun and everything crashes and it all gets bought up, tale as old as time.
How's your boys? Are they fucked?
Probably fucked. Yeah. I mean, definitely.
I know Binance... Fucked. So Binance did it. Binance, there was a report of like their earnings of FTX's returnings.
Yeah, Binance fucked him.
and they looked at it and they were like, yeah, we're pulling the plug on this.
The videos of the dude from Binance talking shit on SBF is hilarious. And then he'll just tweet out like some like almost Q-like tweets where it's like everything's okay, that he's just trying to take us down. Don't worry about it.
You know who else is wrapped up is your other boy, the Citadel guy.
100% not my boy. Ken Griffin?
Ken Griffin. There's clips of Ken Griffin.
Ken Griffin was 100% tied up in this, and then like when this broke, he's on the news like, that's crazy that he was doing that.
Yeah,
they're tied up in Robinhood, all that stuff. I feel fucking bad as shit for people. Like, there was people who, like, teachers unions who were tied up in FTX, and it's like, ah, it is what it is. Sorry about that.
Yeah, that's what Ponzi schemes are, bad, man. And they happen like all the time. There's like a lull, and then there'll be another one because everyone gets greedy. And they're like, oh, I can get this awesome return against the market. That was the thing with Madoff. Like, the market would go down, but Madoff's kept going up.
They made more people.
He would just grab more fresh money, fresh kills. And it was like, it just kept going. And people must know.
Have to.
You know, like people that are in the know, like finance guys, you know, it doesn't take a rocket scientist.
It's like you sussing out a painter, like. Yeah, that dude shouldn't have a Mercedes Sprinter.
This is
like,
fake news.
Makes no sense. So there's other finances involved in this man's operation. Yeah, they're like, that's what used to phase me about. Like, my buddies would talk to me about crypto and be like, oh, dude, you just put it in this wallet and it's a 15% return annually. I was like, no, it's not. Like, that's fake.
I mean,
there's
I know, like, I'm not smart enough to do money stuff, but if you can explain something to me, I'm not that dumb, is what I'm saying. Yeah. Like, I'm not like,
that'd be stupid. You're not dumb. No one's dumb.
If you can't make it make sense to me at all, like, it's something's up. And that's like half the stock market shit. People try to explain to me like what they're up to with their thing and their Vanguard, and I'm just sitting there just going like, dude, what?
Yeah,
it just doesn't make sense to me at all.
I just like that you explain it to me. I understand. If there's no sorcery involved, it's very cut and dry, like, what you're doing. Once you start, like, saying, like, you have to bet on futures and puts, and I was like, bro. Especially, like, when...
The side quests of the investments is what I don't get. And yeah. I get that you're allowed to do that or whatever. It's just it's basically a casino. I understand that it's a casino. I just don't understand how you think this is cool. The house always wins.
Yeah, and especially since, like, they help fund, like, CIA, black ops, and, like, overthrow governments with stock market money.
Well, it also seems like when these
it's like a war chest.
When these guys get propped up and these giant Ponzi schemes are going on, intelligence, if they catch wind of this is just their money. This is like how the intelligence, they just take all the drug money.
Yeah.
So they see
the whole business is there. They just have to walk in like, this is illegal, it's ours now.
This is ours now. So it's like they love letting these
they are the true mafia.
They love letting these things be birthed.
If someone was working on a house and it was mega and all you had to do is go, you're illegal, I'm taking this. You would let the dude build the sickest house in the world and just walk in every time. You'd probably live there for a little while too.
Yeah, I mean, that guy's sitting there on that, that's a regular show. I don't know that guy's name. It's like Chuck Todd or whatever.
I don't know.
The show he's on.
Yeah.
But that's a regular mainstream media show.
About to throw up, he's so nervous.
Yeah, can't stop shaking. And you're telling me, like, they didn't see that kid walk into the studio and just go, yo, maybe not today. You know what I mean? Like, they just sat him down.
It's all this new
lights
shit,
on,
dude.
And that's because he's got a handler. There's guys that walk him in, and they're like, this is what we're doing. This is what he's going to say. This is what question you're going to ask. This is all teleprompter shit.
Susan.
This is Susan, yeah.
It really, like, there's, that dude should be responsible for anything.
Yeah, they're like, oh, we got to get this message, this FTX message out, and it's like, it's cool that it fucked up. It was supposed to fuck up, but in the Whitney Webb thing, they're saying it fucked up too soon. It wasn't supposed to pop off right now. It was supposed to be timed for later. This
two
is just,
more years.
That's just them speculating, but I don't know. I don't know anything about crypto. It's just cool to listen to. It's cool to listen to all the connections with his family being wrapped up in
his
this
shit. His family's
way
tied into literally all aspects of life that is going on right now.
And his little Alameda babe is her dad's connected to. So
the SEC. Yeah, her dad's fucking tied into the SEC, and they were like, yo, chill on that. Like, they were fucking up.
That's what I'm saying. Like, all of this shit's going on, and they're like, dude, they have fucking seven boyfriends.
Is it all dudes?
Oh, I don't know.
I was going to say, ew.
I don't know.
It's called a bukkake.
So you're falling for it.
Huh?
Like, I just said that. You're falling for it.
I know.
Yeah.
Did you believe Will Smith did? Yeah, it is fucking. I was listening to some crazy shit where the chick's dad is like either the ahead of the SEC or some shit, like where he's like, he's up top there, and they were gonna look into it, and he just put the brakes on. I was like, nah, you're not. So you're gonna tell me like that never happens, and the SEC's let shit fly. And if you it's probably no different than the washes. Once they got the FOP stickers, once they stop paying that fucking bill, dude, they get raided. So all you have to do is fucking pay to play.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, I don't know enough about the financial world, but I just know that this is a lot like other shit.
It's like, dude, it literally seems, supposedly, like from the people.
I'm on another, like that, you know, you're bringing me into the financial world, dude. I'm in Camelot.
Yeah, true.
You know,
you're close to Agartha. I was talking to someone the other day and they're like, yeah, you know, like the stuff like Middle Earth and like, you know what I'm talking about? I was like, Agartha. Like, what? I was like, Agartha. What do you mean? She's like I'm talking about Middle Earth. Like, say the right name. It's Agartha. It's where we're from.
Middle Earth is Lord of the Rings.
Is it?
Yeah.
What's Agartha is fucking center, like Middle Earth in Antarctica, right?
I mean, Agartha is like Hollow Earth. But if someone is saying Middle Earth to you,
you can't get that deep.
Do you want? I mean, if someone says
trigger you.
Middle Earth, we're gonna talk about Rings of Power.
Is it done yet?
Yeah, it's way done.
You finish
travesty,
it or no?
It's a travesty, bro.
But you it doesn't bother you?
It's for kids.
Right.
It's cool that kids get in. It's cool to like suck another generation into Tolkien. To get them to read the books, sure. But yeah. I mean, to hold that up as canon? I don't think so. I don't think that could happen. I don't know how we're spanning first and second ages, guys.
What do you... So if... Just real quick.
I don't know how in 10 episodes you're going to span the 120 years it took to forge the rings.
Right now, just curious. It's Thanksgiving. What's table talk going to be like for you? What's going to be on the top of the mind for table talk for you?
I mean, I'm just going to sip some beers and chill. I'm not going to...
You don't think you're
a pop? I don't ruffle feathers. I'm not like you, man. I'm not a provocateur.
I try to.
I try every year. I try to be like, maybe they'll like me this year. Maybe I'll get invited to more stuff.
So you, just
I'm the
chill.
Opposite of you. You're just sitting there like, I can't wait. I can't wait to get into it with the Dems.
Liberal tears.
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, dude, I don't think I've been weaponized at Thanksgiving until like 2 years. Like, I haven't had facts about anything. Like, I just fucking.
The last time I had a thing at Thanksgiving was the what? So funny.
What did you do?
It was when it was right before the fucking election, dude. And I was there.
Which one? 2016 or 2020?
2020. Oof. And I was like, they're not going to believe he lost. I was letting people know.
Yeah.
And then I remember I was talking to someone that was in fucking like healthcare investments. And I was like, you know, John Rumsfeld and Gilead, right? And people were like, dude, it doesn't mean that he's like, because you have Gilead in your portfolio. And they're like, I'm just getting condescended to talk to.
Yeah.
And they're like, well, it doesn't matter if like someone has Gilead in their portfolio. And I was like, he was the CEO.
Did you tell them?
In my head, I'm just going, what the fuck's going on?
Dude, that's
what- I'm a fool. Okay, I don't know anything.
That's what pisses me off, though, because like you obviously have looked into this shit.
And they looked into none of Remdesivir.
They looked into nothing.
Remdesivir iced a fucking generation of dudes that like to party too hard with poppers. Literally iced people. They practiced Remdesivir on kids. There's mass graves in New York. Don't get me fired up. I'm trying to eat turkey.
But I'm just,
trying to get sleepy from food.
But dude, when...
And you're triggering me from 2 years ago. I forgot about this.
I don't think...
I'm not going to walk in there and be like, oh, hey, Kim. And then just start thinking about the fight we had about Remdesivir. But now I am. Now I remember it.
Well, you can just say, you know, who's right?
Yeah, right.
How's those shots? This is literally like my first Thanksgiving since everyone got back together. Like the whole band hasn't been back together for a long time. And I got some libs, I got some centers, I got some libertarians, got some repubs. So, I mean, all I can do is just drop little fucking grenades. Just
that's what I'm saying. That's what you do.
And dude. Walk away.
That's what you do.
Just walk away. Like all
you go around planting mines and hitting flash bombs. That's what dude, you do.
It's like...
I chill.
You walk into a group of boomers and you just... All you have to do, and if there's anyone in the proximity who's close to lib, you just go... Yeah, living in the city is getting tough. And you just walk away. And then it's immediate fucking hellscape.
But I mean, that's what I'm saying,
it's hilarious,
man.
Dude.
I just wait. I speak when spoken to. I'm trying to eat the turkey while it's still hot.
Yeah.
You know, like, I'm not doing this shit, dude. I'm not either. You are the problem. You're part of the fucking problem.
I'm Johnny Appleseed, dude. I'm just dropping them around. It's fun. All you have to do is just hit a little one. And the boomers are the easiest. The boomers, you can just wind them up with the Literally, you just have to look at them and go, and just keep walking away. And they'll just go off, dude.
Yeah, I know.
You just give a big sigh and just be like, have a Fetterman. Leave. It's over, dude. It's 20 minutes of all of them. Like, oh, Fetterman. Yep. Fucking freaking out. Okay, he's got a stroke. He has a stroke. He can't do it.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not doing any of that.
I'm going to have fun.
Yeah,
fun,
you're going to have fun. This is your thing. I'm literally just chilling as hard as possible, dude.
Every time I think I'm going to put the feed bag on there, too, and it never happens. I'll have, like, some good turkey. I go ham on mashed potatoes, and then that's it. I always think I'm going to hit plate, too, and never do. Also, I heard that mac and cheese is for black people on Thanksgiving. We have it every year.
Well.
There was a – my cousin was in a debate.
Maybe you are an Israelite.
My cousin was in it. Like, they were asking him, like, do you have macaroni? And all these people were white. They're like, no, we don't have macaroni. And Pat and the black chick were both like, yeah, we both have macaroni. And they're like, yeah, it's for blacks. How do you figure? Mac and cheese, good.
Yeah, I don't know. I never heard that before.
Maybe I'm just country.
Yeah, I never
that's
heard of that.
I was like, dude, I thought that was normal as fuck. Let us know in the comments below if macaroni and cheese for black people.
Some of the things that you say are insensitive.
I completely thought that was Honkyville. I thought like maybe they make their own version of mac and cheese that's like better than ours. That's all I could think of. But I thought mac and cheese was on the table for Thanksgiving.
I don't see why not. But I mean, obviously,
you can let me know?
You're talking to the wrong dude.
You let me know?
You know, I've just fucked with gobblers.
What do you mean?
I just eat the gobbler. The gobbler meal is what I eat. Mashed at potatoes, cranberry sauce, stuffing, turkey. That's it.
Really?
There's no mac and cheese. So it might just be you.
Maybe I am. Maybe I'm is. I don't know. I mean, dude, I think it's pretty normal, but I'm like kind
of
like.
I don't think it's anything to get bent out of shape about.
I'm not bent out of shape. I'm really surprised.
I mean, you just seem kind of bent out of shape about it.
I'm down with it, brother. I was just saying.
You're putting on a good face.
I'm not putting on any face, dude. I'm just saying, like, maybe try out mac and cheese this year. John's good as well, bro. I mean, anything else to talk about? We have a special guest coming up.
Yeah, we do.
Very special guest.
I hate to tease the page like that. But
it'll be Saturday.
I mean, if this is as good as I think it's going to be, we've been sitting on this for how long? For like a year.
Yeah. Usually, I mean, when it comes to the cast, who it's going to be, usual suspects. But the story,
I'm kind of proud of myself. I never accidentally spilled that because I accidentally spill everything.
I mean, we tried to have primary source on here and he didn't want to come on and big time us. And there's a lot of people out there right now who.
And dude, like, yeah, everyone's big dogging me. Like, I'm writing emails very politely. I don't understand how, like, I don't, like, Whitney, I know I've said some things in the past. And I, I'm a responsible man. And
everyone.
I think we'd have a good time. I just think we would have a good time.
Guys can change, dude. It is crazy because there's people out there right now. And there's some dudes who are absolute fucking beasts. And we will talk to them.
Yeah.
And you reach out to a dude like Cliff Hyde, and you fucking sit there with the caveman text, dude. Yeah. I want to fight you.
Yeah, and then meanwhile, I'm popping up out of the underground in Manhattan, and I'm bumping into Nick Bryant. And Nick Bryant's talking to me about Patreon.
Yeah.
Let's get more Patreons. And I'm like, yeah, well, dude, you got to start putting out some fucking shit on it.
Yeah, obviously.
You know what I mean? And then he's going to blow people's minds pretty soon with his fucking Watergate.
Yeah.
And we got to get the dude on Rogan.
Get his fucking paycheck. Get him on Rogan. Like, Nick then, Bryan is a cool dude.
Yeah, he's a cool dude.
We talked to him. Everything's fine.
Tell him, I was like,
people,
yo, man,
dickheads to us.
I'm emailing people. And he's like, I might be able to help you. And I was like, all right, fingers crossed.
Yeah.
So.
I mean, dude.
Why can't they all just be like that, you know?
December 2nd, I'm on a fucking full-blown crusade. We just want to interview fucking cool people about cool shit. It's not like we're pretty normal dudes.
Yeah.
It's not that bad to talk to us. We're a good fucking hang. We have no ulterior motives. Just a chill sesh.
That's all it is, man.
Open invite anyone. Just hang out. We'll be chilling.
Also, too, T's and P's to Passio. We're trying to get Passio over to my house, but...
Yeah, true.
You know, T's and P's. Send it out. Send out the good vibes.
All natural, all good vibes. Mark Passio. If he needs anything, obviously, dude, if you're hearing this, fucking ask us. We'll help you with literally anything. That's what I'm saying. Like, there's dudes out there. Fucking people need help. Me and you are unlocked. We're not a slave to this world. We can fucking help people. We love. I mean, dude, going on missions, helping people move and shit. Love it. Never ask for fucking cake. Literally, just love moving people. I'm fucking good at it. Helping people out. You call us. Hand up. Service to others. God's literally just unlocking us to be able to serve others and get to the next level. Because I had a bunch of talk last night about the afterlife and passing on. It's fucking crazy. So, just serves others. We can go on with our lives and chill. But also, Cliff High, you're a fucking bitch.
All right, we'll see you on the page.
Saturday.